This episode of DNews is brought to you by Toyota's hydrogen fuel cell vehicles. Leave your mark. Toyota, let's go places. Hydrogen-powered cars are hitting the road this year, and eventually one's gonna be in a crash. So what would happen then? Would it explode? Let's get down to it. Hey everybody, thanks for watching DNews today. I'm Trace. When you think of hydrogen, you probably think of like the sun or the Hindenburg explosion. But hydrogen does so much more than go up in flames, especially when it's looked after properly. Hydrogen is atomic number uno, number one, the bestest element. It burns efficiently, resulting in only water vapor and tiny amounts of nitrates when done at high temperatures. It's made by electrolysis, which is essentially using electrical energy to split water into hydrogen and oxygen. The first time using hydrogen gas as a fuel cell were published, it was the late 1830s, and now, 185 years later, fuel cell cars are heading out onto the roads. We already use it for rocket engines, so why not for cars, guys? When we think of hydrogen on the road, we might worry about tiny little Hindenburgs driving around, right? Which could not be further from the truth. Hydrogen gas is very explosive, it's true. It's even more than natural gas, which is also used in moving vehicles. Gasoline vapor, also explosive, hello! Hydrogen can alight with airborne concentrations as low as 4% or as high as 75%. That's a lot. Even so, gasoline burns at even lower concentrations of 1.1 to 3.3%. I read documents from specialists in hydrogen storage and transportation safety, and they say the concern is if the gas is trapped in an enclosed space. Otherwise, you're probably all right. Hydrogen is way lighter than air, which is why it was, you know, theoretically good for airships. If you were to fill three balloons with natural gas, hydrogen, and helium, and then let them all go, the hydrogen is gonna rise at 45 miles an hour, twice as fast as helium, and six times faster than natural gas. Gasoline is heavy, so it sinks. When a movie needs to make car crashes even more terrible than car crashes already are, they add a small fire and then a huge tank of leaking gasoline, right? Sidebar, why does everybody have a full tank of gas in the movies? You ever thought about that? What about hydrogen? Well, gasoline evaporates slowly, so when a crash occurs, it can drip out. But hydrogen fuel is stored pressurized because it doesn't want to be a liquid. Tanks on board the newest hydrogen cars to enter the US highways are gonna store hydrogen at 10,000 PSI. This means if a crash were to occur between a gasoline car and a hydrogen car, where both of their fuel reservoirs were punctured, the hydrogen car would be safer fuel-wise. If there was a fire, the hydrogen would have burned completely or rapidly, whereas gasoline would burn more slowly as it vaporizes and sinks. But at that point, it would be difficult to tell which wasn't fun. And gasoline's heavier than air vapors would pool around the crash site, providing more burning for any resulting fires. It'd be bad. But when you combine a pressurized tank and a lighter than air gas like hydrogen, usually the result is gonna be dissipation rather than combustion. Which means in a crash, it would almost instantaneously escape into the atmosphere, and that is hardly a Hindenburg. But what about the fueling stations, you might be asking? For people, hydrogen fuel infrastructure is relatively new, but industrial applications of hydrogen have been going on for a long time. Not to mention, people catch their cars on fire at gas stations like all the time. 3,000 times a year. NASA has used liquid hydrogen since the middle of the last century to lift astronauts into orbit, and so far that's been going pretty okay. If a leak is detected, NASA uses helium to flush the liquid hydrogen out into the air, again, so it quickly dissipates. Helium is a noble gas, which means it's super stable and doesn't really combust. With the right safety precautions in place, maybe hydrogen fueling stations will adopt that too. Then if a leak happens, we'll all just sound like chipmunks! Oh my god! A hydrogen leak is adorable! I'm not even mad about it! We'd like to take a second and give a shout out to Toyota for supporting DNews. They were at CES this month and they released their patents for new fuel cell technology and revealed their fuel cell car to the world, the Mirai. They're hoping these royalty-free patents will spurn a hydrogen fuel-based future and spent the last decade reducing the cost of fuel cell production 95%. So what do you think? You still afraid of hydrogen? Let us know down in the comments. Come back and subscribe for more DNews, and thanks for watching. This episode of DNews is brought to you by Toyota's hydrogen fuel cell vehicles. Leave your mark. Toyota, let's go places.